Dear student friends, good evening to all of you. I am Dr. Ganesan, Head Department of Economics, Ayyanar Janaimal College. Today we are going to see about the sources of non-tax revenue. So here, there are different sources of revenue to the government. The sources are classified into two. One is tax sources, or you can tell tax revenue. And the other source is called non-tax source or non-tax revenue. First, we understand about what do you mean by tax. So here, tax is a compulsory levy made and collected by the government from the people. Here, the taxpayer, they won't expect any benefit from, direct benefit from the government. So here, the tax revenue is of two types. One is direct tax revenue and another one is indirect tax revenue. Direct tax and indirect tax. So here, what do you mean by direct tax? Here, direct tax means if the impact and incidents are fall on the same individual, the tax is said to be direct. For example, you take into account of income tax and wealth tax. Here, under income tax and wealth tax, suppose you take into account of income tax, so the government is imposing tax on the income of the people. So here the taxpayer is the tax bearer. So here it's not possible by the taxpayer to transfer his tax burden from his shoulder to somebody else. So on whom the tax is legally imposed, he is the responsible person to pay tax to the government, that is direct. So here the impact and incidents are fall on the same individual. But you take into account of indirect taxes, here the taxpayer and tax bearer are not on the same individual. It is of different individuals. For example, you take into account of sales tax, or you take into account of the GST. Here the government is imposing sales tax on the producer or the seller, but ultimately the seller, he transfer the tax burden either fully or partially from his shoulder to the consumer. So here the impact is on one individual and the incidence is on another person. For example, you take into account of here, impact is on the producer and the incidence is on the consumer. So now we discuss about what do you mean by non-tax revenue. So here under non-tax revenue, the government is doing so many administrative services for the welfare of the people. So to make or to maintain the expenses of the administrative revenue, the government is collecting a nominal amount of money from the people. That sources are called non-tax sources. Here, what are the things which comes under non-tax sources? First, you take here fees, license fees, special assessments, fines and penalties, forfeitures, estates, gifts and grants, and commercial revenue, or you can tell price. These are the things which comes under the non-tax revenue. Now we will discuss the source of non-tax revenue one by one. So here, we have already discussed about the meaning of non-tax revenue. So revenue from administrative functions and also revenue from selling of goods and services by the public sector enterprises. So here you take into account of administrative functions, that is revenue from administrative functions. Here fees, license fees, special assessments, fines and penalties, forfeitures, estates and gifts and grants. All these things which comes under administrative function, that is revenue from administrative functions. And you take into account of the commercial revenue or prices. Many public sector enterprises are run by the government. They are producing goods and services, and that commodities are sold out in the market and they are earning profit. That profits are comes under the commercial revenue. So now we discuss first the administrative revenue one by one. First you take fees. Here fees is nothing but the charge levied by the government to meet the cost of administrative service. So here government is providing many administrative services to the people. For example, you take into account of if a person want to get a income certificate or a community certificate, at that time he has to make fee to the government. So here the charges levied, fee is nothing but the charges levied by the government to meet the cost of administrative services. So it is paid only by the person who receive some benefit from the government. So if I want to get any benefit from the government, at that time only I have to pay fee to the government. So it is not more than the cost of service. So here normally the fee collected by the government is a nominal amount and it is lesser than the cost of service provided by the government to the people. Example, registration fee, tuition fee, insurance fee, etc. Suppose you take into account of a person, a student who is studying in a school or a college, he has to make tuition fee. But the amount is collected is a nominal one, but the government is providing educational service to the students. So, a fee is nothing but the charges levied by the government to meet out the cost of administrative service. Then the second one, license fee. Here, just like fee, here a license fee means charged by the government to give permission to hold something. Suppose if a person want to have a gun, he has to get a license from the government, that is gun license. Suppose if a person wants to open a liquor shop, so here he has to get license from the government. So here, if a person who wants to get permission for making something or for holding something, the government is charging a fee. That fee is called license fee. Example here, license fee for liquor shops and keeping a gun. Then special assessments. So here government is, nowadays the modern government is providing so many welfare programs and welfare functions to the government. So some programs which will increase the value of the asset or the properties in a particular area. So at that time, the government should impose a special tax on the value added of the property or the asset. That is called special assessment. So here special assessment means the value of properties in a particular area appreciated due to the provisions made by the government, like road facilities, drainage facilities, street lights, etc. So here the government may impose a special levy to meet out the expenses incurred. That comes under special assessment. So due to the program introduced by the government, the asset value of that particular area will appreciate it. For that appreciation only, the government is making a tax. That tax is called a special assessment. This tax amount is used to meet out the expenses made by the government to provide the facilities to that particular area. Then you take into account of fines and penalties. So here it is imposed by the government on persons who disobey or break the law. If a person who is breaking the law introduced by the government, or if a person who is not obeying the laws of the government at that time, the fines and penalties are levied by the government. So levied on those who do not fulfill certain requirements. For example, you take into account of traffic rules. If the government is making traffic rules, if a person who is riding the vehicle, if he is not following the traffic rules followed by the government, so at that time the police authorities or the authorities, they make fines and penalties. So here the fines and penalties levied on those who do not fulfill certain requirements. So it is not a revenue motive, but to prevent crime. So here the fines and penalties imposed by the government are not collecting revenue from the people, but to reduce the crime and to make the people to obey the rules and regulations made by the government only, the fines and penalties are imposed. So here these are not the important source of revenue. Here the revenue collected by the government from fines and penalties are a very meager one. So it's not an important source of revenue to the government. Then forfeitures. So here forfeitures is nothing but the penalties imposed by court for failure of individual to appear in the court. Suppose if a person who file a petition in the court, and if the court is asking him to present in front of the court, suppose a person who is denied or who is not present at a particular date at that time, that means he is the person is disobeying the order of the court. So at that time the court is imposing penalties. The penalties are called forfeitures. So forfeitures are the penalties which are imposed by the court on for the failure of individual to appear in the court. Then estate. So here the claim of the government to the property of a person who dies without having any legal rights or without keeping a will. So here estate is nothing but the property of the decaised person, and the decaised person who is not having a legal heir or is not having a will at that time, the property will be taken over by the government. So here that properties are comes under estates. So here next comes under the gifts and grants. So first you take gifts. Gifts are voluntary contributions made by the patriotic people or charitable minded persons for special purposes. Here the amount, the gift will be provided by the people to the government voluntarily, or to meet out some unforeseen circumstances. At that time, government is collecting money from the people. That money is called gifts provided by the government. For example, you take into account of flood relief, or you take into account of the current situation, Corona relief funds. Government, many people are contributing. Even the government servants, or the private individuals, or private industrialists, they are contributing money to the government in the name of Corona relief fund. And also you take into account of defense funds, etc., which are all provided by the patriotic people or the person who is having charitable mind to the government to perform some special purposes. So here, grants from one government to another. Grants means here the one government should provide grants to another government. For example, you take into account of the central government is providing grants to the state government to meet out their expenditures and to perform its programs, and the state government provides grants to the local bodies or local authorities to perform its functions. So grants from, or even grants we can receive from one country to another country, that grants are called foreign aids. So gifts and grants, gifts are the voluntary contribution made by the people, and the grants are received by that is provided by one government to another government. So far we have discussed about the administrative revenue. So here, by performing some administrative functions to meet out the expenditures, government is collecting or charging a nominal amount from the people. So these things which comes under administrative revenues. Now the second type of non-tax revenue is commercial revenues or prices. So here, the income earned by the public enterprises by selling their goods and services. The government sector, public sector enterprises, they are producing goods and services and they are selling the commodity in the market. At that time, they are getting some revenue. That revenues are called commercial revenues, or you can tell it as prices. So for example, you take into account of electricity board, or you take into account of railway. The railways is run by the government. So the government is collecting money from the people, those who travel by train, and that money comes under the revenue to the government. And at the same time, you take into account of the Bharat BHEL, the Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited. They are preparing heavy boilers and they are selling the boilers throughout the country. And here the revenue collected, or the money collected from by selling boiler units, government is getting revenue. That revenues comes under commercial revenue. So commercial revenue is nothing but income earned by the public sector enterprises by selling their goods and services. Thank you, viewers. I think you have some knowledge about, you have gained some knowledge about the sources of non-tax revenue. Kindly go through the video and get more insight about the source of non-tax revenue. Thank you.